Yes, come in.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, have a seat.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
What's your name?
So my name is Anya Jaiswal.
Anya Jaiswal. And what's your name?
So my name is Ikra Rehan.
Ikra Rehan. So your names are Anya and Ikra.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Anya, your code is 15A and Ikra, your code is 15B.
Okay, sir.
Okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, Anya, please tell me something about yourself.
Thank you so much, sir, for allowing me to introduce myself.
Yeah.
My full name is Anya Jaiswal and I hail from Karari, Kaushambi, Uttar Pradesh. I will be turning 18 the following year and currently I am studying in 12th standard in my prestigious school of Kaushambi in Kaushambi Presidency School. My father's name is Mr. Gulab Chandra Jaiswal, who is a definitely successful businessman, and my mother's name is Mrs. Sarita Jaiswal, who is a dedicated and loving housewife. About my hobbies, I would say that I'm particularly fascinated in reading English novels and fictional books, as well as dancing. And last but not the least, about my strength, I personally think and believe that my communication and interaction skill definitely elevate a better version of myself. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Anna, can you tell me about your aim?
Sure, sir. Sir, my objective of life is to serve my nation wholeheartedly, being as an IAS officer.
Okay, very nice.
Thank you, sir.
And what's your favorite subject?
Some my favorite subject, of course, I like reading English books, so my favorite subject is English.
Okay.
Yes.
Very nice. And now, Ikra, please
yes,
tell
sir.
Me something about yourself.
First of all, thank you so much, sir, for giving me this opportunity to introduce myself. My name is Ikra Rehan. I am from Rohi Bharwari, Kaushambi. My father's name is Mr. Rehan Ahmed. He's a government servant. My father is my idol. My mother's name is Mrs. Baby Anjum. She has been a source of inspiration and motivation for me. She's a housemaker. My hobby includes reading English novels, crafting, and playing games like badminton and basketball. And I am a self-motivated.
Okay, and what's your aim?
Sir, I want to become a civil servant.
Okay. And please tell me something about your hometown.
So my hometown have all the facilities, whether it is related to education, medical and marketing facilities. And our school is the best example for excellence academic in our town.
Okay, very nice. Let's move to our next task, that is the topic presentation. And
sir.
Now Anna is going to tell us about
yes.
her topic. When Anna will finish her topic, Ikra, you will ask some questions and also I will ask some more questions.
Okay, sir.
So would you like to begin your topic?
Sure, sir.
Yeah.
So the topic that I am going to talk about today is about Article 370. As we all know, Article 370 has always been a trending and well-known topic ever since it has been abolished from the Constitution of India. The Constitution of India adopted Article 370, it was a time when it was still getting framed. So we can say that Article 370 has always been a part of Constitution of India from the very start. Now I'll come straight to the point. Article 370 was introduced on October 17, 1949, and it ensured that the natives of Jammu and Kashmir can have and enjoy special privileges, status, and it also ensured that none other than the natives of Jammu and Kashmir can own any kind of land in their territory. However, it was a temporary provision, but it also ensured that no other than the natives of Jammu and Kashmir can have any kind of approach to professional, educational or even medical facilities in Jammu and Kashmir. So it was rather rough for all the citizens, but when BJP came in power, its election manifesto clearly and loudly spoke about the scrapping of Article 370. And on finally, I guess it was August 6, 2019, it was the day when the Article 370 was finally abolished from the Constitution of India. That will be all about my topic. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Now, Ikra, would you like to ask questions?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Anya, my question is, according to you, abolishment of Article 370 was a right decision or not?
Ikra, as you asked the question, so I'll reply. According to me, what I personally believe is that abolishment of Article 370 was definitely a great idea because along with the abolishment of Article 370, the structure that was uneven. It means that there is a unification of India, we can say in another way, because now all the states, whether Jammu and Kashmir or the rest of the states, can enjoy the same privileges and status without any discrimination or biasness.
Okay. And Anya, can you tell me some benefits of removal of Article 370?
Yes, sir, definitely. There are so many benefits of removal of Article 370, but I'll list few of them.
Yeah.
So the very first one that I think is the unification of India, as I have said before, because as the removal of Article 370 has been done, there is an integrity in whole India. Whether they belong to Jammu or Kashmir or another state, now they can have fully and legal right to all kind of citizenship and other type of marketing and financial and business, any kind of medical facilities even. Now they all are equal and even.
Okay. Can you tell me something about one nation, one flag? What do you mean by one nation and one flag?
Sir, one nation, one flag. Sir, I'll cut to the chase. One nation, one flag directly means that there is no inequality now. Now, the Constitution of India is same for everyone. No different constitution, no separate flag. One nation, one flag.
Okay. Means Kashmir to Kanyakumari?
Yes, sir.
One nation, one flag.
Yes, sir.
Very nice.
Thank you.
Now, this is your turn. Ikra, you are going to tell us about your topic. And when Ikra will finish her topic, Anya, you will ask some questions.
Okay.
And also I will ask some more questions.
Okay.
Yes, so sir. Would you like to begin your topic?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
I'm going to represent and express my words on the topic smart work versus hard work.
Smart work versus
hard work.
Very nice.
Thank you, sir. In reality, both smart work and hard work are important to gain popularity in any field. Smart work helps the person to complete their tasks efficiently, more tasks in less hours with less resources and reduced efforts. Actually, smart work is the total package of plan plus tools plus labor. However, hard work also helps the person to complete their tasks successfully. But time consumption will be more and there will be no assurance that your tasks can be completed with less resources. In short, with hard work, we can complete our tasks successfully. But in order to gain fame among people and get recognized, smart work matters a lot. In a sense, working hard in a smart way will take your success in your tasks. Smart work is the outcome of the hard work you did in your past. Last but not the least, you can do hard work, but if you don't do smart work, you will work for rest of your life. That's all.
You mean hard work in a right direction?
Yes, sir.
That is smart work.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Anya, would you like to ask questions?
Yes, sir. Sure. So, should I?
Yeah, please.
Ikra, as you said about topics of hard work and smart work, so according to you, which one is more perfect for a student life?
Okay, so according to me, both the cases have their own plus point. One of from both will not be sufficient in this modern world. And since hard work is definitely more important to achieve the goals of our life, whereas smart work leads to shortcut to achieve anything in life. So I think the combination of smart work and hard work is the key to success.
I definitely agree with your point. That will be all.
Ikra, yeah.
Yes.
No achievement without hard work.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Ikra, how you can make your work smart as a student?
So, as a student, firstly, I will make a plan and try to work regularly according to my plan and set up my goal and try to review it and stay healthy and be motivated.
Okay. Very nice.
Yes.
Are you agree?
Yes, sir. Definitely.
Thank
I agree
you so
with
much.
That.
Let's move our next task. That is a problem solving task.
Yes, sir.
Now I am going to provide you a card which has information about a problem. Okay.
Prompt.
Yes, and you have to discuss together.
Okay.
And
sir.
After that, you have to tell me what are the solutions, appropriate solutions.
Okay, sir.
So, can we discuss among ourselves?
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
So this is your prompt. Take it and discuss together.
There are some small houses near your school. Every morning you see the people living there walk a long distance to fetch water. you would like to help them in some way, discuss with your partner.
This is definitely a very serious problem, but I can't say that this is rare. I mean, every second village has this problem of India.
Of course, currently it is the most dangerous street that the earth faces is shortage of water. Water, which is an essential component for our survival on earth, and existence would not have been possible in the absence of water.
I agree, because water is a natural resource. Yeah. With
and it is precious
say,
for
yes,
life.
We can say that water can be termed as life.
Yeah.
Without life,
no life without water.
Yes,
yes, yes. No life without water. And yeah, we can say that no life without life. It
yes,
is same.
It is very precious.
So because this problem is arising so much that there are so many people dying just because of thirst.
Yeah.
On one hand, of the upper societies are wasting your water in useless things. And
yes,
here
so.
There are some villages, not some, there are so many villages that do not even have the approach to drinking water. Such a discrimination. That is
are
the
you agree, Ikra, are you
yes,
agree?
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me something about it?
Okay, so in order to helping them, firstly, I would like to that it's a responsibility for everyone, whether it is about a water corporation and also other upper authorities to provide the facility of safe and clean drinking water. And should also dig a bore well so that village people could get water easily.
So also instead of, because this is so lengthy for students, I
yeah.
don't think that we can just reach the upper society. But what we can do is to save water, to reduce its waste, to reuse
yes,
it.
Sir.
Like the wasted water can be used in watering the plants,
yes.
washing your cars.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes,
awareness
sir.
Among the people.
Yes, awareness among the people. But awareness among ourselves first.
Yeah.
We need to aware our parents. Yes, sir.
We are the future of
yes, sir. We have to apply.
Dream.
We have to change ourselves to change the others. So
yes,
they are the proper measures.
Okay, very
we
nice.
Take.
You have done your task very
thank
well.
You.
Thank you,
sir.
And this is the end of your assessment.
Thank you,
thank
sir.
You very much, and you may go now.
Thank
you,
sir.